problems on the determinant. The problem asks like this: using the properties of determinant and without expanding, show that the determinant value is equal to 0. Already they have mentioned using the properties of determinant. We have to use the properties of determinant, either any of the six properties of determinant, and without expanding. Directly we are not supposed to expand the determinant, and we have to use the properties of determinant to show the LHS is equal to RHS. Here we have to show this determinant value is equal to 0. So consider the determinant value, and in that determinant value, split the third column as sum of two terms. Take the first and second column same, and split the third column. Third column can be split as 63 plus 2, 72 plus 3, 81 plus 5. So look at the last column. Here we have written the terms as sum of two terms. So by applying the property 5, the property 5 says if any rows are, any columns are sum of two or more terms, then the determinant can be expressed as sum of two or more determinants. Here also we can write this determinant as sum of two determinants. So here first and second column are same. 2, 3, 5, 7, 8, 9, and take the first terms for first determinant and second terms for second determinant. So the first terms are 63, 72, 81 plus, and consider the second determinant. For second determinant also, first and second column are same. 2, 3, 5, 7, 8, 9, and the elements are, second terms are 2, 3, 5. So look at the second determinant. In second determinant, first and third column are same. So that the first and third column are identical. C1 and C3 are identical. By the third property, if any rows are, any columns are identical, any two rows or any two columns are identical, so directly you can take the determinant value as 0. So the second determinant value will become 0. Consider the first determinant. So in the first determinant, again consider the third column. So in third column, all the elements are multiples of 9. So you can write those elements like this. So 63 can be written as 9 into 7. 72 can be written as 9 into 8. And 81 can be written as 9 into 9. So look at this example. So here second and third column are proportional to each other, so that they are in the same ratio. By taking 9 common from the third column, then second and third column become identical, so that the determinant value is equal to 0. So the whole determinant value is equal to 0. Next, consider the second example. So here we have to show the determinant value is equal to A minus B into B minus C into C minus C. In matrices, you have already learned how to find the inverse of the matrix using elementary row operation or column operation. So they have used either row operation or column operation throughout the problem. But in determinant, you can use both row and column operation. question to simplify the determinant. So here also we have to simplify the determinant using row or column operation. So let us consider the LHS. A plus B into A minus B. a plus b into a minus b. So look at the third row. So in third row, first element is 0 and second element is c minus a. So we have to prove that is equal to c minus a. Already the element is in the form c minus a. Take the element as say c minus a. Again use the formula c square minus a square. It is also in the form a square minus b square, and it can be written as c plus a into c minus a. In the second row, you can take a minus b as common. From the second row, we can take a minus b as common, and from the third row, we can take c minus a as common. From the second row, a minus b, and from the third row, c minus a. First row is same. Don't change the first row. 1a, a square. Second row becomes 0. And you have taken a minus b as common. The remaining element is minus 1. By taking a minus b as common, remaining element is minus of a plus b. From third row, you are taking c minus a as common. So the row becomes 0, 1, c plus a. Now, the first column having maximum zeros. So expand the determinant along the first column. Here, the first column having maximum zeros, we have to expand the determinant along the first column. You can expand the determinant along any row or any column which is having the maximum zeros. So this is equal to a minus b into c minus a, and expand the determinant along the first column. Here the first element is 1. 1 is in first row and first column. Delete the first row and first column, and remaining elements are minus 1, minus of a plus b, 1, c plus a. So take the cross product. Minus 1 into c plus a, minus c minus a, and minus, and another diagonal. First we have taken this diagonal, minus 1 into this term. So directly I am taking as minus c minus a, and second diagonal. 1 into minus of a plus b. Already the middle side is minus, minus into minus, that becomes plus, a plus b. 1 into a plus b, a plus b. And second and third element are 0. Directly you can take the value as 0 for second and third element. So here, minus a plus a get cancelled. So the remaining element is b minus c. So the whole determinant value is equal to a minus b into b minus c into c minus a. So next consider the third example. So that is, we have to prove the determinant value is equal to a minus b, b minus c into c minus a into a plus b plus c. In previous problem, the first column had the same elements. In this problem, the first row is having the same elements. If the first column having same elements, then we have used the operation R2 minus R1 and R3 minus R1. Here the first row is having the same elements. So we have to use the operation on column. So that is C2 changes to C2 minus C1, and C3 changes to C3 minus C1. So we have to make maximum zeros along the first row. So take the LHS and use the operation C2 changes to C2 minus C1 and C3 changes to 1a cube and second row is changing to c2 minus c1. So subtract c2 elements in c1 element. So in c2 column the first element is 1 and c1 column the first element is 1. So c2 minus c1, 1 minus 1, 0. And again second element is b, here the second element is a. So b minus a, third element is b cube, here the third element is a cube. B cube minus a cube. Next consider the third. Third row is changing to c3 minus c1. So subtract c3 column in c1 column. So here the first element is 1, 1 minus 1, 0. Second element, c minus a. Third element, c cube minus a cube. The ith is seen in the form a minus b into b minus c into c minus a. Look at the second column. It is in the form b minus a. But we have to prove that is equal to a minus b. So to make that a minus b, take minus as common from the second column. By taking minus as common, the elements becomes minus of a minus b and b cube minus a cube becomes minus of a cube minus b. So look at the third column. So third column is in the form c minus a. So no need to change it because we have to show that it is in the form c minus a. Already it is in the form c minus a. Write the third column as same. 0, c minus a, c cube minus a cube. So look at this term. It is in the form of standard formula. So that is a cube minus b cube. We know the formula of a cube minus b cube is a plus b into a square plus ab plus b square. So use the formula. A cube minus b cube formula is a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square. And consider the third column. 0, c minus a. Here also the third element is in the form c cube minus a cube. Again it is in the form a cube minus b cube formula. So c cube minus a cube can be written as c minus a into c square plus c a plus a square. So now we can take a minus b as common from the second column and c minus a as common from the third column. Take a minus b from the second column and c minus a from the third column. And the remaining determinant is in the form 1a a cube 0. We have taken a minus b as common and the remaining element is minus 1. Here minus of a square plus ab plus b square. And the third row is in the form 0. Here we have taken c minus a as common. The remaining element is 1. Third element is c square ca plus a square. So look at here. The first row is having the maximum zeros. So it has converted into simplest form. Now we can expand the determinant along the first row because it containing maximum number of zeros. So expand along first row. By expanding along the row 1, so here the first element is 1, One is in first row and first column. Delete the first row and first column and take the cross product of that. Minus 1 into this term. Minus 1 into c square plus ca plus a square. So that all the terms get multiplied by minus 1. So that becomes minus c square minus ca minus a square. This is first diagonal. Product of first diagonal minus product of second diagonal. Here already minus is there. Minus into minus plus. So this term into one. Same term. A square plus AB plus B square. No need to expand second and third term because 0 is there. 0 into anything. Here minus a square and plus a square get cancelled. So a minus b into c minus a. So look at here. Combine first and last term and minus one term. So that will become b square minus c square and remaining two terms are plus ab minus c. So here the first term is in the form a square minus b square. Apply the a square minus b square formula. So that becomes a minus b into c minus a. Can be written as b plus c into b minus c. Here also we can take a as common. By taking a as common, the remaining element is in the form b minus c. Now, from these two terms, we can take b minus c as common. Take the term b minus c as common. Then the determinant value is equal to a minus b and you are taking b minus c as common. A minus b into b minus c into c minus a and here the remaining elements are b plus c and directly I am writing that as a plus b plus c.